Hello everyone and welcome to episode 2 of the Firecast. It's been a bit since we did the very first episode, so welcome back. Sadly, it won't be on Spotify because I can't do it in Spotify, but here on YouTube, we're doing it again with the only host, me, and then the only other cast member, Stix.
Hello, hello.
Yeah, cat. Cam's gone. Cam's gone. He has to look after dogs. So, rest in peace, Cam. He was a great member. So we have a couple things to talk about, including Roblox UGC Limiteds. We have Pet Simulator drama, Fortnite x Attack on Titans collaboration, Fortnite Creative 2.0 horror maps. I want to just discuss that a little bit. Fortnite Coachella, which just released. Some uploads, the future of uploads, so I'll get more into that. And Stix over here is going to be talking about the Oaklands Easter update and future updates with the game, and also his channel. I have no idea what he's going to say, so we'll see how that goes. and then we'll wrap up the podcast. So, getting into the first thing, how are you doing today?
I'm alright. My arm's a bit sore because I got my cast off from a broken wrist. But
Yeah. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
Your wrist is finally free.
Yep. I hadn't seen it for 5 weeks.
Yeah. It's just like not there.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Well, that's epic. Oh my god! How I just realized. Hang on. Sorry. My avatar moves when I move the camera. I only just realized. Well, I had work today, so it's been quite a productive day. I've got a laptop, as you know, so I've ordered that. So hopefully it comes within the next couple of days, which is awesome. But anyways, so going into the first topic is the Roblox UGC Limited Creations. Now, this is a brand new feature that I believe came out last week, and my goodness, has it blown up. It is huge now, and people are doing like free limiteds. There's literally like Twitter accounts now focused on the limiteds and tracking all the free ones that are coming out, and it's kind of crazy. I mean, I've seen ones of like coins, golden poop. Like, I don't know why that's a thing. I know like counts is so much. Free limiteds going on, and they sell out in seconds. It's actually quite shocking. It's even if they're at like 1,000 in stock, they instantly sell out. It's kind of wild. Yeah, it's wild as. I'm guessing you haven't managed to be able to get one.
I haven't. It's the first time I'm hearing of it, actually.
Oh, you didn't even know about it?
No, I didn't even know about it.
I see. Yeah, I've tracked it, but I haven't gotten it because I've been at work almost every time they release. So it's like, yay. But I know they're selling out real quick. People are getting mad because it's breaking Roblox at this point, which is funny as.
Is it just on the catalog?
Like, yeah, it's just on the marketplace. But because they sell out so quickly, you can't even get one. You can't even realize there's one, which is pretty fun. I mean, it's good that they are able to do that. Everyone was expecting all the prices to go up so high, right? Like, oh, this is a limited. It's going to sell for 5,000 Robux. But now people are just doing it for free.
Oh, real?
Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, it's, I mean, some people are selling it for Robux, which is fair enough. But there's actually a lot of free ones, which I guess is good for most of the players if they can manage to get one.
Oh yeah.
So this also coincides to Pet Simulator. And the whole drama that is going on with them at the moment. I swear the drama is just kicking off for Pet Simulator all of the time. Which is that Preston or Big Games have decided to sell UGC Limited. So the very first one was the Titanic banana, and if you put it on your shoulder, go into the game, it costed around I think six hundred ninety Robux, I believe. And there was like 100 in stock, 100 in stock, maybe 1,000. And if you went into game, you would get a Titanic banana.
Oh, really?
Yeah, a Titanic banana. Which is shocking as. I mean, it was completely free. It was literally a Titanic. You could ride it and everything. And then just the other day, they released another one for 5k in stock. It costed 5 grand. And it was a pink balloon bunny. Which was a huge. Which doesn't make much sense when you're selling the Titanic for cheaper. Yet, the huge pet, which is worse, is way more, with way more in stock. It really didn't add up too much. And holy, it blew a storm on Twitter. People were furiated about that. And people bought it, of course. It took a couple days to completely sell out. I don't even know if it's sold out now. Hang on, let me just check. Because I know there's a whole frenzy on it. And you can't actually get rid of the pet. Like, even if you... It's not even sold out now. It's 2,393 sold out of 7,500.
And it costs
5,000. Wow. And it costs 5,000 Robux. And people were trying to delete this pet, but because they have the item, they can never get rid of it, basically. They delete it, and then they just go back in. But what a waste. Like, especially when you have the banana one, which was literally a time before, and now you're just getting... I mean, you're just getting a huge out of this one. It's like, it doesn't really make sense too much.
Yeah, you would think that Titanic is more expensive.
Yeah, for sure. It doesn't add up, really. The banana Titanic was 690 Robux. I'm just checking it here. And I'm just like, dude, why is that? And Twitter just blew a storm on it. YouTubers were mad. Normal players were mad. The leaking accounts were mad. It was actually pretty crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, is it like? I mean, they sold like a huge balloon for 20,000 Robux. So I guess it isn't as bad as that. But when you sell a Titanic pet for cheaper beforehand, it's kind of like a slap in the face. And they said 5,000 in stock, and now there's 7,500 in stock. So I really am not too sure about what's going on there, to be honest. So you're gonna pick one up? You're gonna spend 5k?
I don't reckon.
Nah, I mean that's just like a waste. It might be a cool item.
I mean, unless Mr. Beast gives me money, then sure.
Yeah, you know, Mr. Beast donates me like 1 million Robux. Yeah, maybe I'll spend a couple dollars here and there on it, but other than that, nah.
Yeah.
That can stay out of my inventory. So moving on to Fortnite news. They've just had a brand new update, and it is the Fortnite X Attack on Titans collab. And wow. Holy moly. I can't believe they're doing a collab between Fortnite and Attack on Titans. I mean, we knew Eren Jaeger was the secret skin, so that's cool in itself. But we have two new skins. Yeah. We have the OBM gear in it, and the Thunder Spear.
Thunder Spear is by far the worst mythic, in my opinion.
It is trash. It is terrible. There's nothing good about it. But the OBM gear is so good. It's like Spider-Man.
Yeah, yeah. It took me at least a whole day of just trying to grind to get that Thunder Spear one done. Challenge done.
Really?
It was painful.
I haven't really played it much, because I'll talk about that later, but from what I've seen, I really like the method, the OBM, because it's like you can swing around, there's like a cooldown as such of like not usages, kind of, but more like the jetpack almost. Of course, we got the new skins as well, which are cool, and the bundle, that's awesome. I love this. There was a guy on Twitter, I think his name's Justin or something. He was complaining about them. Like, really? Saying, oh wow, this is so plain. Why would anyone get this? This is such a bad collab because it's so plain. But it's like, people don't buy it because it looks cool usually, especially for collabs. They buy it because it's a collab they like, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, geez, dude, just like, be happy. Just, you, if you have nothing nice to say, just don't say it, because he gets into controversy a lot, which is super funny.
My personal opinion on anime and that, I don't watch it, but I mean, I've enjoyed the event, or the update that they have.
Agreed, yeah, I don't watch anime or them. I watched like a couple episodes of Attack on Titan, so that's about it. I gotta rewatch it, but yeah, nah, it's a cool collab. I respect it a lot. I'm happy for the people who love Attack on Titans. I mean, that's just awesome for them that they get to experience such a cool collab.
For Fortnite as well. They keep on bringing these banger collabs.
I know. And it's like every season now for the anime.
Yeah.
Hey, it's like since chapter 3, season 3, it's always anime.
Last season they had My Hero Academia.
That was an underwhelming one, actually. Yeah, the skins were amazing, but the Thunder Smash.
Too long.
Oh my god, they said it would last 2 weeks. It lasted like a whole month. Whole season. Yeah, it was like, bruh, can you just get rid of it? And it's like a worse version of Kamehameha, but it's so annoying still. Yeah. It was so annoying. But yeah, I'm glad they didn't overpower the mythics this time. It should be buffed a little bit, though. I think it's too weak.
Yeah,
but
yeah, you see they nerf the Havoc shotgun.
Yeah, that's only important for Zio build, to be honest, because it still does over 200. So if you're in build mode, you're all good. Yeah. So yeah, I call it a nerf for Zio build, to be honest. Not so much.
Build
mode, because I mean you still one pump pretty easily in build, because well hey you only have 200 health. So yeah, it's pretty good. I'm glad they're here. The emotes are funny. It's like all traversal emotes, it's like running away emotes, which is kind of cool. They brought back so many icon series emotes, it's amazing.
Have every single one of them in the item shop at the moment.
No, they don't have Don't Start Now yet.
Oh, yeah.
I'm still waiting for that one. But I have got, they brought back the Gritty, they brought back Crazy Boy Fishing. You know, I got the Rickroll emote, which is funny as.
Yeah.
I bought many emotes. Yeah, it's so funny, because Zanny was like, you know, I gifted it, Cal gifted it to me, but then I realized that, you know, he Rickrolled me because you see the emote when you claim it.
Yeah.
So it's like he secretly got Rickrolled, which was funny as. Well, it was someone, I think it might have been you who gifted him it.
No, I gifted him one of the yellow ones.
Oh, the Gritty.
Remember
the Gritty.
Yeah, Gritty.
Yeah, the Gritty. Ooh. Nah, man, what a good emote that one is, eh?
Yeah, it's so good.
So, moving on to the Fortnite Creative 2.0 horror maps. Have you played any horror maps since?
Me, Zenny, and Kale all played, like, three of them.
Yeah, because I played one.
FNAF one. We played the FNAF one.
FNAF one?
So it's like a murder, cops and runners, but, like, murders and runners.
Ah.
It's... So you're in the Freddy pizza place, which I might add, the movie's coming out.
Like, yes, I was going to say, the movie is out October. Amazing. Holy.
Yeah, and so you have the two hiders or whatever. You got to hide and run away from the actual, like, from the animatronic, which you are.
Mm-hmm.
And you got to try to pickaxe them to pull them in there. No. The other ones, there's this one where it's a scary doll which you have to go and find like 10 teddies or something, and you have to open. It's like doors, but like a long time.
Right.
and like not as much things.
Yeah, because I played a couple, including like a banana one. Banana one's pretty cool. It's so cool that you can do cutscenes and like custom music now, because it just adds to it. It's like, you know, it actually becomes scary. Yeah. It's so cool. But yeah, no, a lot of creators have been doing a really good job with the hover maps, even like normal maps. Like, I played a prop hunt the other day, and that was really exciting. That was fun as, because like the map's so cool now, and there was like a moving peely, and it was so cool. And even like,
you
want to
know what my favorite one is?
What is it?
My current favorite one is OG Battle Royale.
The what one? The
Not Atlas.
Oh yeah, reboot.
Yeah, reboot.
Yeah, reboot Royale is so good. I need to play it again since the newest update, but what a game that is. It's so good. They've recreated it so well. That
so nostalgic.
Yeah, because usually, like, before Creative 2.0, you would, you know, play an OG, and you'd play one game, and you'd be like, man, this sucks.
Yeah.
Now it's like, wow, this is actually good, so we play it a lot now.
Yep.
And on the topic of that, I mean, there's even a Roblox creation now of Fortnite. It's called, I think, Tropical Royale. I played it. It's pretty alright. It gives me Island Royale vibes. Yeah, you know, it's okay. I like the map. The map's cool, but all the guns are basically the same, and they've just added shockwaves in, so it's like, you know. Yes, it's here and there. So, moving on to the last Fortnite topic of today is Fortnite Coachella. So, there's actually been a bit of drama with this. So, Coachella has been celebrated in Fortnite again, and there are two new skins. So there's rewards as well on a website, but we're not going to talk about that. We're going to be talking about the skins. So these skins, a lot of players are disappointed in, because they are just reskins of two other existing Coachella skins. However, with like new effects and everything. But in my opinion, I like them. They're pretty cool.
Yeah.
I like the female one because it's like orange. And then on a ultra, on like a special style, it's like yellow as well. So that one's pretty cool. But I mean, it's I understand where people are coming from, because it's practically just the same skins as before, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like, you know, I mean, they look awesome. I like the pickaxes and back blings. But, you know, it's a bit hit or miss, to be honest. I mean, it's 2,000 V-Bucks for the entire bundle. The music pack is amazing. You can get that as a reward. It's so good. I love it.
Yeah.
You heard it?
Yeah, I had a look at it before, actually.
So what do you think about the skins?
Yeah, they're alright. I mean, definitely not the best skins, but, like, they're other pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I reckon it'd be worth picking up, to be honest. And we also have two new emotes, which are copyrighted, which are, yeah, they're right. I wish they were a bit more vibey, to be honest. That's right, you know. Get what we get. I'm just so happy we got the Icon Series emote. Actually, I just realized the Icon Series emotes are probably back for this.
Yeah, probably.
For Coachella, because even though it's been, you know, here for like a week or two, I mean, it's Coachella now, isn't it? So it kind of adds up with this whole collab thing in the long run, so that's pretty cool. I like that. And the loading screen I do like as well, so. Hey, it's pretty good if you ask me.
Yeah.
Actually, I just realized, is that loading screen you get from the website the same one in the bundle? I think it is.
Might be.
Maybe. I'm really not too sure, to be honest. Alrighty, so moving on is about the uploads of this channel for the near future, for the next, I'd say about 2 to 3 months. So Uploads are going to be very vast, I would say, apart from the Firecast and maybe a few commentary videos here and there. There will be no uploads, simply because I'm working on Project Egypt. So this is a massive project that I'm taking on. I'm hoping to get it done in 3 months. I'm hoping for the release date of around August for this, but Stix over here is involved with it too.
Yep.
And I've got a lot of people on board, and I'll play a clip from what I've created of it so far. It's gonna be a short clip, so here it is. I don't know what you've been told. So hopefully it's gonna be good. In saying that though, you just gotta be patient. It's going to take a while. To make this good, you need a lot of time, and hopefully it's gotta be good. So don't expect like any more documentaries for a while. In saying that though, I haven't even done one for ages anyway. But when I get back, I am planning some new documentaries and stuff, kind of like the Pit Simulator one. I was gonna do a Pit Simulator 2022 recap, however, my editing software, the subtitles are kind of screwed up, so I can't. It's not as good as it's gonna be, so I'm just not gonna do it until later on when I get a new editing software. However, that brings me to my next point of my next video. So, I haven't posted a video in quite a while, apart from the jailbreak season video, about 5 days ago. And the next video is a Fortnite one. It's the Fortnite Pistol Challenge. And this is inspired by Chewy Cat. And I'm excited to get that out because he wants to see it. So I'm gonna make him see it by having it in his feed. So it's gonna be cool. I finished recording that yesterday. I'm not gonna give anything away, but it was more of an easier challenge than I thought. However, it did take a while, so be on the lookout for that. But yeah, for the moment, there's not going to be many uploads apart from commentaries, because they're pretty easy to make, and Firecast, because, well, I love Firecast is great when we have all the cast, you know?
Yeah.
You know? Maybe we need to record on a different day.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. So we're going to move on from that to Stix over here, who's gonna explain the Oaklands Easter update and future updates. So you've just told me you're gonna speak about this, so
yes,
here's the stage.
So a couple, I think it was 4 or 5 days ago, Oaklands had an update. It was 14 days ago. Oaklands had the first update in a while, and it was the April Fool's update, and yeah. I hated it. basically, there was a nuke in store you could buy, and like a full-on nuke you could buy for like $250. Jeez. And every time you brought it, it would just shoot up into the sky and explode. Like you couldn't store it, you couldn't like collect it. And then they also had these like axes that were called the tallest refined axe, because they're refined. The tall refined axe is the rarest thing in the game at the moment. It's only been brought out once in 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
And they brought out the tallest refined axe, which when you brought it, it started bouncing away.
Bouncy.
Like, literally, you would buy it, take it outside, and it would just start bouncing away.
Mm-hmm.
And then if you managed to hold it there and then open it, the axe would just shoot up and never come back down.
Damn.
And yeah, I decided not to make a video on that because it was pretty pointless.
Nah, you did, but then you deleted it.
I did. I made it and then I deleted it because it was a rough video. I didn't enjoy making that one.
Mm-hmm. Fair enough.
So I scratched that, and then in last weekend when Easter came around, they had an update which brought the new currency along that was eggs, egg currency.
Mm-hmm.
And there was this, like, shelter. I've got a video on it on my YouTube channel covering everything, but, like, it had, we have six new gifts. They all cost the egg currency. And every 10 minutes, egg hunt would happen, which eggs would just start spawning around the map, and then you could start collecting them all.
Mm-hmm.
And there's different rarity of different eggs that gave you more of the currency. Like, the basic egg will give you one, the colored eggs will give you two, the rainbow and noob heads gave you like 5 to 15, and then there was the golden egg, which gave you 50.
Ah.
And you could spend that at the Easter stall at the front of the Oak Depot, which is the main store, and buy gifts that you can't open for another 10 or so days.
I see.
And I will be, covering a video over that, opening them.
So make sure to check that out. Make sure to check that out in the future. I don't know when you're going to post it, but link in description.
Most likely the day after the event's ended.
When does it end?
The 28th, I think. Or 26th or 28th. So.
Damn, that's a long event. Wow.
Yeah, it's the first three-week event that's happening.
But, sheesh.
Yeah, and also, for the future updates of Oakland, they have announced logic. So, like, cables, pressure plates, automated machines, and all that.
Mm-hmm.
So you can make, like, an elevator, you can make, like, an auto unloader, which you already Ooh. Can, but, like, even more specific and all that.
That'd be helpful.
They did mention in their Discord that this will take a while, so don't expect it to come out anytime soon, because logic is a very hard thing to code.
That is true. Yeah, no, a lot of coding would go into that.
Yeah, so I'm not expecting that to come out for 3 more months or 2 more months, but I think the next update they would have for Oaklands is the 1st of July, I think.
Fourth of July.
Yeah.
Wait, is that when the next update?
I think that's the next
that's
update.
That's a long time.
Yeah.
That's a very long time.
I mean, I'm pretty sure there'll be a content update in between, but like...
You'd hope so.
The next... Yeah, yeah. They've been a bit slack on that recently, I must say. But I mean, they're like young creators, so I don't blame them.
Yeah. I mean, that's like all of us, though, eh? Apart from holidays now, but like, once we're back, and it's not yay. it's not amazing, to be honest. But I
take me back to that horror school.
Damn.
Don't like it.
Oh man.
Only got one more year left after this year, so.
Yeah, not too long to go. It's actually going pretty fast though, to be honest.
Definitely. Definitely going fast.
But yeah, it is what it is. So what is the future of your channel looking like?
Okay, so my videos, they are currently all based on Oaklands updates, and every time there's an update in Oaklands, I'll cover it, except the April Fool's ones, which nobody likes.
Fair enough.
My next video that I'm planning on is a side video with Fortnite.
Mm-hmm.
I recently released a video of just a random squad win that I got 21 kills or something with.
Which was pretty epic.
Yeah. I know it was a replay and it didn't... Like, it wasn't smooth. It was a bit glitchy at times. But yeah, I'm working on a way to get that running.
What you need to do?
Yeah, I need to just have. I've got it already. Like, I just need to turn record full sessions on.
Yeah, and also get rid of that bar, the replay bar.
Yeah.
Like, put it on a gameplay, not thing.
Yeah.
Oh man, that was funny. I was like, There we go.
That's the first time I'd used replay.
Yeah, no, that's all good.
So the next video that I'm planning to do is a challenge on Fortnite with the boys.
The boys.
It's gonna be it's nothing crazy, but it's a don't touch the floor challenge, like floor's lava challenge. You can't touch the floor at all. You have to build over everything and all that stuff.
That's gonna be hell. Like,
which is gonna be hectic. It's gonna be hectic. There's gonna be a lot of fails and all that. But
rage compilations.
Yeah, I actually am thinking about doing that. I'll be recording the whole 6 hours if it takes to record that.
I reckon it's gonna take a while. We're not stopping until we win. I got work, please. Please save me.
Well, I mean, we don't have to record, like...
Yeah, I know.
Do it different days, isn't it?
And
if there is an Oaklands update before that, I'll be covering that before that's released, because that's the main part of the channel. Fortnite's just like a side thing I'm working on at the moment.
Little side hustle.
Yeah, little side hustle.
That's like me, to be honest.
Yeah, and I'm also waiting for, you know, the old sub count to go up, because that's been a bit of a standstill at the moment.
Same.
I actually excited to announce that once I hit the big 100 subscribers, there's going to be a huge giveaway.
What? Can you tell us what the giveaway is?
It is going to be in Robux currency, so Robux.
Fellas, if you are here till the end and you want free Bobux, make sure to head over to 6YT on YouTube, link in description, and you'll be able to enter if you hit the subscribe button.
By the way, that stream, I'll be streaming it, so that stream will be in Oakland.
And so I see you're copying me, yes.
Yeah,
totally all my idea, you know, completely original, me doing that.
How else am I supposed to do it?
Yeah, no, that's true.
Yeah, other way to do it, but...
I mean, we'll see what happens, shall we? I mean, I'm hoping mine goes up. I have some pretty big ideas in the work. Well, not in the works, but it's all planned. I have, like, a list of ideas. But this YouTuber, Skate, by the way, he's already taken one of them. So, that's fun. Really? Yeah. Story of L Splash, a.k.a. the game Doors. Which is what I was going to do, but... That's all good. I'm thinking about doing jailbreak.
I can still do it. Just make it better.
Yeah, but, you know, time. But yeah, I'm excited for Project Egypt, though. Once we start filming, which should be next week, I reckon it will be a banger. It's going to be different.
Crazy.
And it's going to be in jailbreak. So that's all I'm going to say on that note. So yeah, it's gonna be epic. The future's looking bright. Hopefully my sub count can go up. It's, you know, sure it's not going up, but that's okay. You know, my commentary videos are doing pretty well. You know, they're getting like 100 views, which is pretty good, and it's like consistent as well.
Yeah.
So I can't really complain about that, to be honest. But on that note, I think that's everything. Do you have anything else you want to talk about, or...
Well, there's one thing, but it's completely off topic to everything.
Yeah, like go. That. Doesn't matter.
Messi in football, Lionel Messi.
He's
transferring out of PSG and was almost 100% returning back to Barcelona, which I'm happy about.
Really?
Yep.
No.
He did not renew his contract, and Xavier, which is the boss of Barcelona, is in talks with Messi for his return.
Oh my goodness.
And he got offered a $400 million contract in Saudi Arabia.
But
he turned that down. He turned that down, which is double what Ronaldo makes. He turned that down to go back to Barcelona.
Damn.
A lot of his a lot of his fans are happy about. He made a good choice there, I reckon.
I'd agree with that.
Chose passion over money.
Yep, no, I agree with that. Sweet, well, I think that is about it for this episode of the Firecast. Hopefully you did enjoy, of course. Make sure to join the Discord server, join the gang, have a good time, link in description. And we will see you in the next episode, or if I do a commentary video, my next video or Firecast episode 3. Once again, thank you, Stix, for joining us once again.
No problem.
Let's pretend Cam's here as well. Goodbye, Cam. And I'll see you guys in the next one. I'll see you guys in the next one. See ya.
Bye.